You had a question?
Yes, thank you, Madam Chair. Dr. Christian, if I could, please. And then just a statement after that. But
sure.
If I could call your attention to page 2 of your testimony.
Sure.
The third paragraph.
Yep.
The importance of a child protective service worker obtaining information. You said at the end, the last sentence, not following up with certain medical needs or that he or she has significant developmental concerns about the child. Just can you help me understand what those developmental concerns are? The physical, educational, mental, does that encompass all of it?
So, sure. A physician, mine is in large font. I got to get to the right paragraph
okay,
that you're
I'm
on.
Sorry.
That's okay. That's my eyes. Sure. There's federal law, okay, the Fostering Connections and Improving Outcomes Act, that mandates now that child welfare agencies across the United States not only provides for safety and permanence for children who are victims of abuse and are in foster care, but also for their health and well-being, okay? And doctors are in charge of a child's health and well-being, including, for example, the development of a child. So a child whose motor development, who, you know, children walk and run and jump and skip and talk and understand and learn, that's child development. And if a child is in, let's say, child welfare custody or in foster care, and this child's got significant developmental delays, it means that child needs some intervention. That's things that pediatricians follow, that developmental pediatricians assess, and that is important for the child welfare agency to know so that they can ensure that the child gets into the appropriate therapies. So it's all about the health and the well-being of children. And while I'm up here, may I make one clarification?
Certainly.
The way that Senate bill reads, it doesn't mandate that physicians send children and youth agencies all the medical records for the children. It says that they share relevant medical information. And, you know, not only about a bruise, but again, if children and youth is trying to ensure the health and the well-being of children and understanding what their risks are, knowing that the child is healthy is important. A physician can help a children and youth worker understand what they're looking at because, you know, every day in Pennsylvania, children and youth workers are making decisions without the proper medical input. And if they are allowed to have conversations and work with physicians who know the child and physicians who know medicine and injury mechanisms, will have better outcomes and will have better decision making and will leave families alone who don't need to be involved in child welfare, but will be able to better protect children who require protections.
Well, I just wanted to
sorry,
be,
I'm sorry, I went off.
I wanted to be clear that the significant developmental could also include a little more broadly than just physical.
Correct.
Nature. Just a comment, Madam Chair, because I can look at this a little different, I'm sure, than some people. When we talk about homeschooling and people who are being home educated, I know that there are some eyes that will roll back in the head when they think, well, there's nobody who would actually target somebody who homeschools. But let me say, as the one homeschooled graduate who serves in the legislature, I can speak well that is not the case, that you do have people out there who can imply that homeschool children are somehow being abused simply by being homeschooled. I had heard all the comments about that I would be socially awkward, that I couldn't put two sentences together, which I think we've pretty much put some of those thoughts to rest, or that I would be a mama's boy, which maybe my wife would agree with at this point. But, so I've lived that, and I've been through that. So I think we should just all keep that in mind, that even though to us saying that somebody who is homeschooled or is who being home educated, well, that would no physician, no family physician, no county work, nobody would ever specifically target somebody for being homeschooled. I think we do need to walk in those shoes for a little bit and make sure that this law does not have unintended consequences. Thank you.